Hey guys, welcome to my channel. For today's video, I am going to be doing kind of my first impressions on Rare Beauty by Selena Gomez. Okay, let me be completely honest with you. I really wasn't that excited about this launch. Not that I'm the gatekeeper of who makes a makeup brand, but just for me personally, nothing against Selena Gomez, but I don't really think of her when it comes to makeup. Like, she never does any crazy looks or bold looks. Like, she's not known for her makeup. People don't talk about her makeup. I will say, I do love her makeup artist. I followed him for a very long time. Like, I think he does a fabulous job with her and his other clients, but Selena herself, I didn't see this coming. It didn't really interest me. However, I definitely had FOMO because this is quite a trending topic in the beauty community, and a lot of you guys were actually curious on my thoughts, so I was like, you know, I'll just do a video. And I mean, I've watched a few reviews. It definitely got me more curious. I do like the aesthetic of the brand, and I will say, it does look very well done. I think them launching in Sephora right away also gives them a little bit of street cred. Yeah, I just don't think of Selena as a makeup person, which is why I wasn't really that intrigued by the brand at first. But she obviously has a very dedicated audience and fan base, so whatever she does, she's gonna make a lot of money off of. I bought at least one formula of everything except for the eyeliner, because I bought a lot of liquid liners lately, so I just didn't want to add another one. I didn't buy the brushes or the blotting powder or anything like that either. And then I also didn't buy setting mists because I have so many. I have a whole drawer full of setting mists, so I was like, I can hold off on that. But I did get everything else, so I guess let's just put it on my face because this is probably the millionth review that you've seen. So we'll start off with the primer. So I got the Always an Optimist base. So this is supposed to be an illuminating base. I did buy the mini. This was the only mini that they had. I wish that they had more minis, like a mini highlighter, mini foundation, because I don't need to be spending money on full price items. But anyway, the mini illuminator is $14 and it is made in Italy. And I love makeup products made in Italy, so I'm happy they sourced this from there. Let's do this. And I mean, the aesthetic of the brand though, really nice. They are plastic, it's not glass. I think the illuminating highlighter is glass, but the rest are plastic, which I like because I feel like I drop makeup all the time. I'd just rather have it be plastic and not break. This is what it's looking like. You guys, I got into a fight with a friend over here, and the friend clearly won. I mean, base, it's not super sticky. It goes into the skin nicely, and I do think it gave me a little bit of a nice illumination. I mean, primer's a primer. I like this. I think it gave me a nice illuminating base without being too obnoxious. Yeah, okay, this is cool. Actually, let me zoom you guys in so you can get a closer look at my acne. Alrighty, so I had to get my hands on the Liquid Touch Weightless Foundation. Gosh, I love the frosted packaging. I know people were saying they're copying Fenty, which yeah, definitely looks inspired by Fenty, but it's super nice though. I got mine in the shade 210N. No idea if this is actually my shade, and this is made in Canada. It's $29, which is not bad. How does this work? Oh. Okay, I know some people hate the doe foots because of bacteria and contamination, but whatever. But I like it. Okay, I probably put too much on for testing, and I always use a sponge to apply foundation, and 210N is a pretty good color for me. Maybe like a touch too deep, but ooh, I like this. This is nice. I think I put a little bit too much on to start. This is probably the equivalent to 1.5 layers. I'm not applying this with a brush. I don't know how this applies with a brush, but I already can tell you I really like the application with a sponge. Are we really doing yard work right now? Are we really doing this? And it's really loud. Let's get a little closer here. I have like, what just happened? I wouldn't say it's like a super luminous foundation, but it has more of a natural finish, which I think is going to pair well with that primer. And I would say it had a light medium coverage. I mean, I can still see my freckles through. You can still see my friend. I did apply a lot of product, so I definitely think if you apply less product than I did, you could get more of a light coverage. But I would definitely say this is light to a medium kind of coverage. Honestly, after watching the reviews, I thought I was gonna get get less coverage. I mean, my skin is relatively behaved right now, so I really like this level of coverage. I will say I do have a little bit of pores emphasized in this area, but that's been the trend lately with all foundations, so I think it's me, not the foundation. Ooh, and it feels really nice. Okay, so I actually really like this foundation. I think it looks super nice. It feels very comfortable, and it evened my skin out perfectly, and I really like this color. So I also got the concealer, of course. I also picked it up in 210, and the concealer is made in Italy, and this is $19. I think these mid-range items are very fairly priced. Now, this is coming from somebody who does have a large amount of luxury makeup in her collection, but $19 is not bad. Let us take a dive in. We're gonna do just some in this area. I do think getting the foundation and the concealer in the same shade worked out. Like, I think the concealer is just a bit brighter than the foundation. This is supposed to have a medium radiant kind of coverage. I'm not going into detail as much as I normally do just because there's so many other reviews, but I mean, this looks nice. I wouldn't say this concealer is anything to call home about so far. It did give me a medium coverage, definitely not the fullest coverage. I'm gonna do just a touch more. Let me see how it covers my friend for scientific purposes. I definitely would give this guy a medium coverage, and it works well, but I don't think it's anything groundbreaking. But of course, we'll see how it wears. Now, she doesn't have any powder products in her line right now, so I'm gonna set one side of my face in a few moments. But next, let's move on to the eyebrows. I almost didn't pick this up, but I go through brow products pretty quickly, so I was like, let me just do this. This is the Brow Harmony Pencil and Gel. It's $22. I got mine in the shade Cool Brown. It does not have a spoolie on it, so I have to go elsewhere to get a spoolie. Honestly, I just prefer my brow products to have a spoolie and not like the extra gel, because a spoolie is key for me to do my brows. So on one side, the first side, you can see here is the shape. So it's a little bit thicker. It's not going to give you those super defined, precise hair-like strokes. It's always so interesting to me to see where they make these. Made in Korea. Lots of brow products are made in Korea. We're going to go for it. Okay, so immediately, it is kind of hard to control this because it's that weird triangle shape. I don't really like that about this. I think if you're trying to go in and do your eyebrows really quickly, like if you have naturally thick eyebrows that don't need too much precise defining, I think this is nice, quick, and easy. But I do prefer a little bit of a thinner eyebrow pencil, and it's very creamy, which is a good thing, but it's almost depositing like too much color for me. But the color is blending out. But if you're looking to get hair-like strokes, you're not going to get that with this. I was hoping it would be a little bit waxier, because I don't mind a thicker eyebrow pencil. I love the 8 Cosmetics Brow Power. Like, that's the perfect amount of thickness, but I still have control. This one, because it's both creamy and an odd shape, I don't find it to be the easiest to work with. This is a good color for me though, and I like that it's actually a really cool brown, because sometimes when they say it's cool, it's a little bit more warm. And then on the other side, you get the brow gel. I do like a tinted brow gel, and I mean, this is nice. It's hard to tell how much pigmentation this has because I do already have some color in. But like I said, I would prefer just a regular spoolie, just pay for the pencil and maybe have this as a secondary product. That's honestly just a me problem. It definitely does add some volume and fullness to the brow, which is very nice and trendy. You know what? My brows are looking good. I don't think this is a bad product, but it's not for me. Next, let's move on to the blush. So these are the products that I probably was the most excited about. These are the Soft Pinch Liquid Blushes. They are $20 each, and they are made in Korea. So she has two finishes, a radiant finish and a matte finish. I got one from each, and I've watched the tutorials. I've seen that these are very pigmented, so I'm not gonna make the mistake that everybody else did. But the color that I was most excited for was Bliss, and this is the matte finish one, and I just think this color is gonna be gorgeous. I think the packaging of this is super cute. Ugh, I'm dying for this color. So I'm just gonna put just that, you guys. And I always like to just use my sponge. Oh my gosh, yes. It is so pigmented. I don't think it's blending out super seamlessly, if I'm being honest. And make sure when you're using a sponge to blend products out that you're using tapping motions. One thing that I am disappointed that this line didn't have was a cream like bronzer product or contour or something to add that depth. I feel like since they did all of this cream, they could have added that in as well. Okay, so with a sponge, at least, the Bliss shade blends out to be a very light, natural, sheer color. But obviously, I've seen the tutorials. If you apply too much, it gets difficult to deal with. But I think it blended into the foundation seamlessly. That also has to do with my application. I find using patting motions with a sponge to be pretty foolproof. Works almost all the time, even with difficult products. And it gave me a very light, natural flush. Honestly, I could probably do like a touch more. I didn't find this product to be super easy to blend out though. I found even with my sponge, and why I like to use a sponge is because it has such a big base. So normally the product will spread throughout the whole bottom so it evenly disperses the color everywhere. This formula wasn't super easy to blend out. I'm being very, very picky though with that. That's just what I'm noticing. And then I did get one dewy finish in the shade Joy, and this looks a little bit brighter. I think she has a really great range of colors throughout the whole line for a lot of different skin tones. Foundation, concealer, the blushes look like they have very skin tone friendly choices. This is gonna be a bit brighter. So this one is very, very pigmented. Let's try and sheer it out. This one has a lot more color, but I mean, immediately you could tell just by looking here that this one was gonna have a lot more color. I think I prefer the dewy formula. I think it's a bit easier to work with. Just with the vibe of her brand, I think it's a lot more complementary to the base products. Ooh, I really like that. And this does sheer out nicely, but if you apply too much product to begin with, you might have a few problems. Ooh, but I really like the dewy formula better. I like the Bliss color better, but I like this formula better. I was very, very excited about these. I think so far they're pretty nice. We'll let them kind of settle in a little bit. I did also end up picking up a liquid luminizer. I wasn't going to pick this up initially because, quite frankly, you guys, I don't like liquid illuminators. I never have any luck with any of them. I'm just not a fan in general. They end up sitting in my collection, but this color looked so pretty. So this is a plastic bottle. I thought it was glass, but it looks like glass, but it's plastic. This is the Positive Light Liquid Luminizer. It's $22. I got the shade Mesmerize, which is a rose bronze, and I got it for this color specifically. We're gonna see, we're gonna test out the formula. Like I said, very picky here. I feel like with all liquid luminizers, they pick up foundation. It's just gonna happen. This is made in Italy. Okay, so I'm gonna put just like that. And I like this color because I felt like it was gonna look really good with pink blushes. And use tapping motions. Again, she has a lot of colors in this range for a lot of skin tones. So I think the range itself was very well thought out. At first, I was liking it. The more I've blended it out, the more it's sunken into the skin. It does look like a glow from within, which is nice, but I was expecting a bit more. It does look a little bit clumpy mixed in with that foundation, you guys. Let me try my finger. I really don't like using my finger to blend products in, but I just feel like you get a softer blend with a sponge. It looks better with a finger, I think. It might just be this color, but when I put it on, I feel like, oh my gosh, this is gonna be such a pretty liquid luminizer, and my fingernails are covered in foundation. I need to cut them. It needs built up to get a bigger glow, which I think is nice. We all like to start softer and then be able to build it up, but I do think it blends out to be quite natural. I'm on the fence about this. I don't think it's bad, and it didn't really move or disrupt the foundation too much, but it also didn't blend seamlessly in with the foundation, if that makes sense. Like, I can see a little bit of disruption happening, like a touch. Nobody else is gonna notice it besides me, but I'm hypercritical of liquid highlighters because I just don't like them. I don't think they're worth the trouble. I think this luminizer is okay, and it's not that luminizing, but that just might be the color that I chose. For sake of testing purposes, I'm gonna set this side of my face. And by the way, I don't know if you can tell, but The concealer is seeping into my creases already, which happens, but I'm just noting it. All right, so I'm gonna pop a bit of the Milk Makeup Blur setting powder onto the under eyes, literally just a touch, because this is a brand where powder's not the vibe. So I'm just putting some on the areas that I need to. So I'm going to finish my eye makeup and then we'll be back to play with the lip products. All right, so I just did big fat wings, a little bit of gold shadow, and a little bit of mascara to keep the eyes very simple. And we're gonna move on to the lip products. So she has two formulas. I picked up one of the With Gratitude Dewy Lip Balm. This is $16. I got mine in the shade Praise and it is made in Korea. And that's the swatch. This looks super gorgeous. So I'm just gonna put it on. It has a good amount of pigmentation for a lip balm. These tinted lip balms are very popular this time of year, even though you really can't wear this underneath a mask because it's gonna transfer, but it's super comfortable. It has kind of weird packaging. It's like flat, but I do just lay it flat and it doesn't roll away, which is kind of nice. This is really nice. I definitely would want to use like a lip liner or something underneath, and it is a little bit, like you can feel it seeping into my lines a little bit, which isn't very flattering. But for the most part to throw on, I think this is nice. It gives a nice little bit of color. I don't think it's anything to write home about by any means, but you know, that's the kind of item that's gonna need constantly reapplied. But okay, so let's move on to the Lip Souffle Matte Creams. I've been very curious about these. I picked up two colors. She has quite a range. These are $20. They are also made in Korea. So I picked up the shades Courage and Brave. These just look like two colors that I would actually wear, and they have like nice soft matte touch packaging. And here's what the applicator is looking like. So this is like a mauve-y brown, really beautiful for fall. So this is Courage. The blushes have stained my hands. And now let's try Brave. So Brave is a little bit more orangey terracotta. I'll try both on, but let's try on Courage first. The formula and finish of this reminds me of the NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams. That's what I would compare these to. I'd argue that the NYX gives off a little bit more color though. This is a little bit more sheer. That's a beautiful color. This is my kind of fall color. I love it. It has a little bit of purpliness to it, though I do think it's a little bit more sheer than I was expecting. I wouldn't really call it a liquid lipstick. I'm gonna take this off and we'll really test the wear time of Brave. It did stain my lips a little bit. Oh, yes. This color is beautiful for fall, you guys. So it's a type of formula where it's almost like a blotted look. So it's gonna be hard to get a really defined edge to the lips, which I think is just a nice change. It's a little bit softer. I love this color. I think I really like this formula. Before we get on with the wear test, I'm quickly gonna go over the products once more. So I think so far, first impressions, the primer is nice. I have other primers like this, but I do think it's nice. I like that it's mini. I think $14 is a very fair price, and I think it does give the skin a very nice natural glow. I think this even looks good on its own without a foundation. So I do like this a lot. I also really do like the foundation. I think it gives a really nice finish, very natural. It applies super easily. Obviously the wear test is gonna tell all, but on initial application, I do like this a lot. The concealer, I'm not really moved by. It's really starting to seep into my lines already. It definitely works better with a powder. So I would recommend applying just a touch of powder to make the wear time better, but I definitely don't think this is anything special. I don't think the eyebrow product is really for me either. I really like the gel. I think it added some nice volume and my brows do feel set in place, but the pencil itself I think is a little bit too creamy and I think the shape is odd. I find it hard to work with. The blushes, I had super high expectations for them. I think they're nice. I think I prefer the dewy formula, but they didn't move my foundation and they look really nice and healthy on the cheek. So I definitely think so far these are worth looking into. They're nice. The liquid highlighter, not too big of a fan of. I feel like it just kind of almost disappeared into my skin. I'm not a liquid highlighter person, so I'm probably not the person you want to watch for true information on this because I never like liquid highlighters and this one is really no different. I think the dewy lip balm, it's nice. it's not necessary. But if you want some color that's really comfortable and shiny on the lips, it's really nice, but don't wear it with a mask and be prepared for constant reapplications. It's a nice formula. I do think it's a little bit too wet though. I feel like it would move around a lot. So yeah, the Lip Souffle creams so far I'm really liking. I love her color range. It doesn't fully set down. It is matte and I can kind of feel like drying my lips a touch. So definitely still moisturize beforehand. It's not a transfer proof product, but it kind of has like a dusty powdery look on the lips, which I really like. That is pretty comfortable. So far, I'm liking these. So it's almost 1 o'clock. I'm going to check back in with you guys in a few hours. Hi guys. So it is about 5 o'clock. So I thought I would check in with you guys. I'm looking pretty good. So I've had this stuff on for about 4 hours and I'm not mad about it. As far as my base is looking, it's looking not too dewy or oily, which I really like. So I think this foundation is going to be appropriate for even maybe oily skin. I will say it doesn't have as skin-like as of a finish as I would have expected it to have. So while the coverage is light, it sits on the skin. Like, you can see that I'm wearing makeup. I don't think it looks bad at all. It does make my complexion look good, but you can tell, like, this ain't my skin. The concealer, definitely set it with some powder. There is a considerably larger amount of creasing happening compared to the powdered side. So just that little bit of powder makes a difference. I wish I would have applied just a touch more blush because the color has faded a little bit and I like more blush to begin with. So I would start a little bit heavier. The highlight looks good, but you know, I just don't really like the highlight to begin with. The eyebrows are holding on strong. I really like the gel side. So I wish the gel was sold separately because I don't care for the pencil, but the gel side has really made my eyebrows budge proof. Not too much sinking in going on for my lines. And then for my lips, I did just reapply, but I really do like this lip product. It didn't leave my lips dry or crackly. I did eat lunch and it kind of settles into your lips and stains your lips. So even while it rubs off, it still looks very good. And the longer you have it on, the less transferable it is. So I think, you know, if you go like that, it will come off. But after you've worn it for some time, for the most part, it does stick pretty well on your lips without being overly drying. So far, so good. I will come back in the next, I want to say probably 3 to 4 hours. It is 9 o'clock. It is past my bedtime, but we have hit the 8 hour wear mark. I didn't really do anything today. I did get back from a walk, but it wasn't that hot out, so I didn't deal with too much humidity or anything. Let's take a closer look. I think I look really good actually for 8 hours. My nose is definitely a little bit on the oily side, and obviously if I went outside and temperatures and heat, we would not look this good right now, but I'm actually very impressed with the complexion. It didn't seep too much into my smile lines. So I can easily tell you what I like and what I don't like. I really am enjoying the primer a lot. I don't know that it did anything to transform my makeup today, but I just love the way that it looked on the skin. So I'm gonna have to continue using this, but I really love the finish and glow that it gave my skin. Really enjoying the foundation as well. I think you can build it up to a medium coverage, but for the most part, I would say it is a lighter coverage. Coverage foundation. It feels very light on the skin. I like the way that it wore. It didn't seem to seep into too many lines on my face. I think this is a solid foundation. I don't like the concealer though. I think my under eyes look a little bit heavy. They look dry. They look creasy. I don't know. I just feel like there's a lot better concealers. Now this isn't horrible, but the foundation is just in comparison so much better than the concealer. The eyebrow product, I like it. I don't love it. It's one of those products where I wouldn't repurchase it when I'm done. Actually, I really don't like the pencil side. It's just too creamy and it's a horrible shape. It's hard to control. But the gel is kind of amazing, you guys. I really feel like it put my brows in place, gave them some volume. So I like half of the product. The other half, I don't see myself reaching for very much. The blushes, I want to play with these some more. I think I really do like them. I think they did fade on me a little bit. I want to try different ways of application. I think applying this with the brush or like mixing it out with a brush or my fingers is going to give me better long-lasting results. So I'm gonna have to update you guys, but I really enjoy the colors of this line. I think I like the dewy finish more, but again, I wanna give these another chance. So sorry, it is a first impression, but I do think I like these, but I need to play with them some more. Not a big fan of the liquid highlighter. I just, It looked very nice and reflective by swatch on my skin. It does give a nice glow from within, but it just kind of disappeared on my skin, I felt, and I'm just not feeling it. The Dewy Lip Balm, now I only wore it for a total of 30 seconds, but my only real concern with this is I think it's a bit too wet to where it could get all over your face. So I would wear something underneath this, but to kind of do a thin layer just like this to moisturize the lips, I think it's fine, but if you really layer on a lot of product, I think you're gonna have a lot of problems with longevity. There's a lot of different lip balm products out right now. I don't think this is anything special, but it's nice and it does give you some good pigmentation. And then finally, we have the Lip Soufflés. I think these might be my favorite in the line. I'm not 100% sure because I really do like the primer and I really do like the foundation as well. But today, what has impressed me the most are these because I'm not a big matte lip person, but I found these to be very comfortable. I really love the colors. I love the blurred lip kind of look. You're not getting full opacity, which I really like. They last a long time as well. So overall, I definitely think there are some hits in here. I think there are some things that are probably overrated that I would save my money on if I were you. But overall, I do think it's a solid launch. I did enjoy doing this wear test. I will continue wearing these products this month and I will give you guys an update because this is only my first time. Overall, quite solid, and the prices of these I think are very fair given the quality. Like, I don't think we are given drugstore quality at this high-end price, which is also very nice. So I approve for the most part. So that's all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would absolutely love it if you would consider to take the time to do so. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.